That to keep an eye on. Also, our local forecast, which has been a bit dreary and damp this morning so far. You can see the capital city behind us. Looks like things are improving as you head north.
Yeah, most areas have dried out. Now, we still just have a little bit of light rain still along the coastline down around Point Judith. Still a little bit damp in parts of Aquidneck Island, too. And you can see those overcast skies here from Narragansett. It stayed cool through the morning. We're still in the 50s, but we are drier and going to eventually turn a little brighter. So North Scituate roadways are going to be in good shape for those headed out to grab a little lunch or run some errands this afternoon. And we still see, again, some of those lighter showers down near New Bedford. Block Island has had a rainy morning, and those showers, again, continuing over parts of Jamestown right now and along parts of our beaches. So at Watch Hill, still having a raincoat up if you're taking a walk there. Our live Doppler radar, though, showing the wider view. The rain is pulling away. We're going to gradually improve and dry things out through the day. More showers are ahead. Not much for Tuesday. There may be an isolated shower or sprinkle in a few spots, but then a better chance for some showers Wednesday, followed by some cooler weather at the end of the week. Upper 50s to around 60 right now. It's a big difference from yesterday. We're about 5 to 10 degrees cooler than yesterday at noon, and the northeast winds are sustained at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. They won't strengthen much through the day either, but they will turn a little more eastward. So we're looking at skies gradually turning partly sunny, 65 degrees today for the high temperature. There's our system that brought the rainfall yesterday. You can see that eastward progress of us. It's pushing away, and high pressure is going to try to build in. So with that, we are going to see some thinning out of the clouds, and at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, there may be still a little bit of dampness along the coastline, but sky's clearing out. The evening commute looking good, much easier than the morning drive, with temperatures still at 5 o'clock between the lower 60s and upper 50s. By 11 o'clock tonight, lower 50s, and the late night lows tonight dropping to the upper 40s to near 50 degrees in the Providence area. And it's a dry night for us. Tomorrow's mainly dry too. You can see a little extra cloud cover passing through and a possible sprinkle or light shower, but majority of the day is going to be dry. Then on Wednesday, strong cold front coming in, but not till the evening and night. This is 10 o'clock at night, so that'll give us most of the day Wednesday on the warm and dry side of that front. Looking at our tropical satellite, so we do have two named storms out there right now. Kind of tough to make out much of a circulation at the moment with Gamma, but Delta here in the Caribbean forming, and that looks to be the main system. So Gamma is going to be interacting still with the Yucatan Peninsula, and with that, it is expected to weaken or even just completely dissipate, and we'll see Delta take over most of the energy here that's available in the Gulf of Mexico. And right now, the forecast calls for this to strengthen to a Category 2 hurricane before approaching this port. Gulf Coast region already hit with several storms this year, and this one looking to hit somewhere between, say, western Louisiana and the Florida Panhandle as potentially a Category 2 storm. 7-day forecast. We've got those showers coming to an end this morning. Isolated shower Tuesday. Wednesday is the warmest day of the week in the lower 70s, with that shower possible in the evening. Then cool, dry, windy for Thursday. Friday's chilly to start and a high in the upper 50s. We're going to warm back up heading into the upcoming weekend with highs in the upper